Hi all and welcome. Just looking at the Queen here in Martin Place in Sydney, and you can see the flowers and the aura there. Now you can see the two entities, cherubim-like entities, around, and I would suggest within that kind, within the kind of aura or fields or layers around the Queen. And in India, you can see very similar configurations compared with what you can see in Martin Place. Among other aspects within Martin Place, you have the cornucopia there also. The goddess or maiden in this case is holding it at the base chakra level, around that level it would appear. In Sydney, you have the Sephora cosmetic chain, a French cosmetic chain shop there. I just took a photo of that, reminding one of the Kabbalah. In this shot, you can see the grand gates to Centennial Park. Now within Centennial Park, it's a very, there's a lot of occultism going on there, but beyond that, in this shot we can see this pole, and you can see the symbology of the caduceus, the double-headed eagle, the sun and the moon. And in this case, in sun and moon combined, in what this case is perhaps the central column of the human being, strangely enough, within the auspice of one being up through the chakras. So you have the double-headed eagle there. Now, in other depictions of, first up, the double-headed eagle would align in Freemasonry, particularly with the 32nd and 33rd degree. And beyond that, if we just look at the double-headed eagle, in this shot, you can see the eagle kind of emerging from the tree, the emergence from the foliage. And so I would suggest that the eagle is an elemental, an emanation from the energy of the fixed zodiacal sign of Scorpio. Now, in India, you can see the double-headed eagle and what is perhaps a chaos, a chaotic manifestation going on. And this is at a temple in Kaladi in India. And further within this temple, you can see this depiction with the scorpion right there also, perhaps reminding us also of the fixed zodiacal sign. Further at Kaladi, you have this depiction that is very cornucopia-like. It looks very, with what is perhaps an emergence. And in this case, you have the parent feeding its young, much like the pelican feeding its young within Freemasonry. So the double-headed eagle would be a kind of emergence from the tree of light, the tree of life. I would certainly suspect, looking at various images, and with these elemental creatures, you have the, as I say, the emergence from the mouth. Yeah, you know, and in this depiction here with the crown, and you can see the crown above the head, but here you see that kind of auric field, that alchemical flask, that genie's bottle. In this case, with the double-headed eagle, among other aspects, you can see the kind of wand in the claw there, with the foliage on it, and you see the sword also, in this case holding the sword. Now, with this depiction of the sword, you can see the light going up the sword in a way from the hand, and of course the hand would be a portal and the sword would be a kind of imbued extension from the hand, and you can see the waviness of the sword. Within the Sydney Masonic Centre in the museum, you can see the sword there, and it is aligned with fire. It's a lightsaber. Now, with each aspect emerging from the center, each aspect would have, you know, the element of fire and water, for example, this kind of separation, sun and the moon, these various energies emanating out of the various directions of the central pillar.